Good morning, everyone. Tina Spaulding, Trance Channel, here today for our the 13th morning session of 40 days and 40 nights. I'm repeating myself. Thank you for joining me. Let's see what Jesus has to say to us today. You are blessed beings indeed. I am that one that you know as Jesus, and circumstances shift and change like the tides on your planet. It is very important at this time not for you not to be so deceived by form. Form is always deceptive because it is the end result of many, many years of feelings and thoughts. So when you see something manifested like riots in the streets, or fires in the woods, you are seeing the end result of a lot of energy. And when you see that event from the eyes of the uneducated, you think it means that things are getting worse. Well, what it actually means is that things have been worse. The manifestation is the end result of a lot of negative thinking or a lot of fearful thinking or a lot of violent thinking. So we want you to shift and change your ideas about form and see the physical manifestations on your planet as the end result of a lot of time, which means you are beginning to step back from thinking that the present manifestation is a portent of the future. The future will be coming from the frequencies that you are all holding today. Now, there are two scenarios at play here. There are the blueprint scenarios, the fateful scenarios, we will say, where things are predestined and they will happen regardless of what you do. It is sort of like getting pregnant. You know a baby's coming. There's nothing you can do about it now. The seed has been sown and a baby is coming. So at 4 or 5 months old, 4 or 5 months pregnant, you can't undo what has been triggered. And there are things on your planet that are going to be happening that are very much like the birth of a baby. The seeds have been sown long ago. The purpose of the transformations has been set by powers that are more influential than you know. And so there are certain things that are going to happen on your planet, and the ascension is one of them. The ascension is one of them. It is a time of energetic shift that will, to use the old phrase, separate the wheat from the chaff. So what's going to happen, and there are beings that say no matter what happens, all of you will ascend. And it is true, eventually all of you will go through this process of going from 3D to 5D. You will become loving people. You will have heaven on earth. But if you are not doing it within the end of this spiritual season, you will be given an opportunity to work through it in another spiritual season. You are not punished. You are merely given your papers saying, you didn't quite make the grade here, you're going to need to repeat the lessons. So there's this idea that there is a punishing God that's going to say, you weren't good enough, you get to be punished. That's not it at all. It is a case of reaping what you sow. These old phrases are coming back from those of you that have read the Bible and have studied these teachings in that form. You reap what you sow. The wheat shall be separated from the chaff. That means that there is going to be a different experience for those that are loving, those that have dealt with their resentments, those that are striving for peace. Or we would prefer to say relaxing into peace, because thriving is very much a 3D kind of idea. There are many beings who are using their free will to indulge in violence. There are many beings who are using their free will and their tremendous creative power to wreak havoc. And they will reap the harvest of those seeds sown It is not a threat. It is simply how the 3D world works. It is a reflective universe. So if you sow the seeds of havoc and division and violence and manipulation and control, you will experience those things yourself, magnified. If you are working on forgiveness, listening to your heart, following along a path of nonviolence and self-expression that does not hurt others, then you will be on a different trajectory than the others that are service to self. And this is how you learn. It is not a punishment. It is not a reward system. It is simply how you learn. When a child touches a hot stove, they get burnt. They learn. They don't touch the hot stove. It is a natural consequence. There are natural consequences for all of you. If you run fast holding scissors, you may not fare so well. If you walk slowly holding scissors properly, you'll do okay. It is not a punishment from God if you trip and fall and stab yourself with the scissors. It is a consequence, a natural consequence of a poor decision using your free will. So today we emphasize your free will. Make sure that today you understand that every single thing you think, every single thing you do, which means it is supported by belief and thought, your behavior comes from belief and thought. Understand that you are planting the seeds in the future garden that you will harvest the fruits from. So let us say that again. Every thought, word, and deed that you are engaged in is planting a seed for a future garden for you. So if you are doing A Course in Miracles and you are doing your forgiveness work when you get upset at people, when you feel a negative emotion, you investigate and ask, what has come up in me? Let me deal with this. We are not expecting perfection. It is the intention behind what you are doing that is revealing your beliefs and your frequency. Even though you may have deeply ingrained conditioned beliefs and ideas in your mind, you are using your free will to deconstruct them. So do not be frightened if you are not perfect. Do not be frightened if you still get upset at people or you still have anger or any of these sorts of things. But look at the intention behind the plan for your day to day. Look at the intention. Is your intention loving and good? That is what is sowing the seed. The past training that you are attempting to overcome is not the seed. So when you encounter your negative conditioned mind, come at it lovingly. Don't panic. Don't think, oh, this is going to keep me stuck in 3D for another 25,000 years. Don't think that. Understand that your intention to dissolve it is the frequency. I am that one that you know as Jesus, and I will speak to you again later. Oh, wow. Okay. Thank you for joining me this morning. I'll see you later. Bye.